Recording and action.
Right, Stephen, let's have a look at our time machine. We've spent a few months building this, haven't we? We've had some help, we've had a lot of fun along the way. It's our version of the time machine. Certainly not accurate as to the film, but representative. And depending on what junk we could get our hands on, didn't it, Steve? So we've got a control panel, which is an old writing bureau that's been thrown out. We've stuffed into that bits and bobs of old technology. We've got an old radio with an illuminated dial and a little miniature television, which we think is from the early 70s perhaps. And we've got some old silent movies playing on that at the moment. We've got a DVD hidden down in the bottom here, where we play old films. A couple of joysticks, controls, and some great pulling levers here that go like that. They're made from some bits of shapes from, these are from an old bed where you had a plastic slot and the piece of wood went through like that into the slot and it was the underside of the bed. We can saw it out, and then we've got these pieces of wood here from the chair, and then these the balls are screwed onto the top. Behind that we've got a wonderful sort of it's just a radio alarm clock, but it's in the shape of an instrument panel from an aeroplane, and we were given that, so that looks great. It doesn't do much, it's got great knobs and levers on it. Set of flashing lights, put those on, you can see those, just hooked up to a battery, and those little bulbs are just from a discount shop, very cheap, so that's lovely. And these clocks here, an old cine camera. You can put slides on too. We've got a little slide viewer there. You can push down and look at slides. There's a load of slides here, you can put those in. Just for the fun of it. And then this thing here, which is supposed to be a bit like a projector, is actually two little wheels from a wheelchair. So they just look good, the paint looks gold, and they look good. And there's a touch light on either side as well as the TV. So we're really happy with the control panel. Then in the middle here, whereas in the film it's a single seat, we've got an ottoman, so it's a three-seater. So three people can travel through time at the same time if they want to. And this is all more or less stuff we've either found or been donated, so we're really happy. Show the back then, Steve, come on. The back is simply a big wooden disc, which a good friend of ours has helped to construct. He's sawed it out for his workshop at home and put it onto a spindle, so it just spins by hand like that. The general idea is that if people want to have a look and have a go at it, they spin it from the back like that. This is free moving, and what we've done to decorate the back, because otherwise it would just be blank, is we've put all the pictures and bits of information about vintage sci-fi, literary sci-fi, H.G. Wells, Jules Verne, Mary Shelley, and all that kind of era stuff, War of the Worlds. So people can turn the wheel and look at the pictures and stuff on the back. On this side, we've got some flashing siren lights, which we'll just plug in. See those working? And also a lamp at the top, like that, just to give it an effect. So you end up with this kind of effect. It's all interactive, isn't it, Steve? Okay. And this, the stand in the middle here, which we've got to hold this whole thing, is a coffee table. So everything is very fortunate, everything just came together from nowhere, really. So I just guess we're just lucky like that, aren't we, Steve? Hey, we're lucky. Stuff comes from nowhere. And we get to use it, so it's very lucky.
That's it?
Yeah.